We are going to be checking out Peter Frampton live. Do you feel like we do? Let's go. Okay, we're going to be checking out Do You Feel Like We Do live. And I'm going to review this and react to it. So here we go. Never seen the live version before, though.
And now, once again, Mr. Peter Frampton.
This is really good quality. This is really, really good quality, and I've only heard the studio version, so this is going to be really fun to watch. Such good editing and sound is just incredible. Wow. I love how into it he is. Oh, I love the breakdown. I love how slow it got all of a sudden. It's nice. Thank you.
my favorite part of this song. I love it when artists have this type of passion. This sounds so good live. Let's talk about it.
Okay, let's check out the meaning of the song Do You Feel Like We Do by Peter Frampton. It was from an album called Frampton's Camel in 1973, charted at 39 in the UK and number 10, in America. It says, this song is about a hangover. Frampton would often write from experience, and at the time, he was experiencing the effects of a night of drinking. When he woke up that morning, there was a wine glass in by his bed, and he wondered how it got there. Whose wine? What wine? Where the hell did I dine? Wow. It said, still hungover, Frampton went to rehearsal and somehow remembered some of the chords he was playing the night before on his acoustic guitar. The band hashed out the tune and told Frampton to come up with some lyrics, to which he replied, I can't. I have a really bad hangover. His bandmates told him to just write about it, which he did. Wow. And it says, after forming Humble Pie in 1969, Peter Frampton left the band in 1971 and embarked on a solo career. Do You Feel Like We Do was released in 1973 on his second album, which was named after his backing group, Frampton's Camel. This version runs 6 minutes and 32 seconds, but which is often extended during live shows. Yeah, the live show we just reacted to was, I think, 10 minutes, where the band would do lots of improvisations during the song, often with Frampton scat singing parts of it, always a crowd favorite. Frampton kept refining the song, which was recorded live on November 22nd, 1975. Yep. During a sold-out show at the Memorial Hall at sunny Plattsburgh. Hope I'm saying that right. This recording was included in the 1976 landmark double album, Frampton Comes Alive, which shot Frampton to stardom and became the best-selling live album ever, at least until live albums by Garth Brooks, Bruce Springsteen, and the Eagles surpassed it. On this live version, Frampton used a talk box, which I knew about, because I have heard the song before and I have looked up what a talk box is, so I've seen a bunch of people use it. A device hooked up to his guitar amp that allowed him to make distorted vocal sounds through a tube in his mouth. Other groups had success with the device around the time Aerosmith used it on Sweet Emotion the year before, but Frampton became most associated with it, thanks to his talk box solo on this song. Wow. It said, Frampton took it to a whole new level. Every time he formed words, the crowd went nuts, especially when it sounded out, I want to thank you, which some people think it sounds like I want to F you, but it's not. It's I want to thank you. I got it. Some teenagers were crafting homemade talk boxes to imitate Frampton, often learning lessons on the dangers of electricity along the way. Oh, wow. I'm learning a lot. Not just about the song, but how the album and everything else came about. I'm definitely going to have to read the rest of this, and I'm sorry if I've read a lot of it. I just got really interested because I've only heard a few of his songs, so if any of you all have more suggestions, songs I probably haven't heard this, I've heard this song, and I think I've heard a few other ones, but I'm not as familiar with most of his songs, but this specific one I am, but somebody requested the live version. And to the person who requested the live version, I liked it a lot. I think I liked it better than the studio version, actually. I could hear everything perfectly, but let me know in the comments what you think about this song and which live version you like the best, and if I should review the studio album later down the line, like other songs from this album or other albums of his. But thank you so much for requesting this. Please like, comment, subscribe, click the notification bell to get notified for new and upcoming reaction videos. My Facebook is at Have a Very Nice Day, and always thank you all for watching and keep on rocking. Peace.